you know, if you see an Egyptian work in some way, if they show you a relief on the test, you'll be able to figure out that it's from the Egyptian period based on, you know, the fact that there was like a specific canon. Okay, and canon is what again? What does that word mean? Canon. What's a canon? Yeah. Yeah. It's just think of rules. It's the rules for the way that something is depicted. The canon. Okay? So you've got frontal shoulders. The rest of the body is in profile. Remember, profile is like sideways. And then the eye is facing front. The head, the legs are often in different directions. Men are taller, often red or brown. Women are shorter, sometimes painted like yellowish. And just like the little feet that you see down below this text box, there's rarely any shading, right? Like there's, you know, nothing to make it look like it's like three-dimensional. Okay, who is my form ninja? Who are my form ninjas from Tuesday night? Form ninja. Any other form ninjas? Okay, so in order to make something look like it has form, right, if it's two-dimensional, you shade it. But there is rarely any shading here. They're depicted as calm and rational, right? Look at our little scribe over there in the, excuse me, in the right-hand corner. Figures are on a ground line and in registers. Right, Beatrice? Registers.
Oh, yeah. Got it.
Cash registers. Love it. No one in here can forget what the word register means. Okay? Or Beatrice is going to be offended. Beatrice, you just offended Beatrice. Yes. Horrible.
You're horrible.
Anybody seen that SNL skit?
You're horrible.
Oh God, I'm so old.
Oh yeah.
You know. You know. Things told like in a story, like in rows, okay? And then the only time where we see that little blip is the Armana period, when Akhenaten decides he's going to have a more shapely figure, more elongated, a little bit androgynous.
Is this
what
is the image just described here from the
It's not, but we'll get to it. So I think
because it's just it's weird because it's a full 3D, very realistic.
Yeah, it is, and he's flabby, right?
Yeah,
it's got some chunk down here, right? So it's kind of goes against this, and we will, and I want you to like think about that and speculate about that, and we'll get to it, because he kind of breaks some of those, some of that, some of the, thank you, oh my gosh, who said that? Air high five me, good girl.
All right.
What's that? She helped me out with the word canon. Yep. He brought in the elongated face, the elongated torso, shapely. Yeah, next.
It's also creatine.
Say it again.
It's also creatine.
I missed that. I'm going
it's
deaf.
It's also creatine.
Yes. Unity.
Yeah.
Unity Ninja. Yeah, you were a Unity Ninja too. Good. Third time's a charm. I'm so tired. I can't hear anything. I can't talk. Okay. So, let's take a look at the palette of Narmer, all right? The first thing that we want to do is we want to just, like, describe what we see there, okay? So this is considered to be the front, okay? We've got Narmer in the center. He's wearing the white crown of Upper Egypt. He's got the royal beard and a kilt on. To his left So this piece, you have to know this piece. And you have to know the details in this piece, okay? This is like, you know, throw it down kind of stuff, all right? Yeah. Can you go write that question up on the question thing? Or maybe how it is? All right, we've got the sandal bearer next to him. He's actually carrying his sandals. Wouldn't that be nice to have somebody carry your smelly sandals around for you?
Oh, wait.
Yeah, good. You did. Yep. No, go ahead. Say it again.
They took off the sandals because whenever he was on the ground.
Yes. Yep. Good. Yeah.
But it refers to garments built associated
with up. That's okay.
No, I just didn't write that sentence wrong.
Yeah, that's fine.
No, I read it in the wrong order.
He's striking down his bow. It's the mace pose, right? And this is used for the next 3,000 years. And then above the foe, we have the falcon with a human arm. And this is the god of Horus. He's shown holding a rope, pulling back the foe's head. And he is emerging from the marsh. There's a lot going on there, right? Anybody know?
Sky and kingship. Wait, did I already say that?
No.
Oh, sky and kingship.
Yeah. Why don't we write that question up there? Okay, Alex, can you write that question up there on our little question board? Bless you. Write the question that you asked. Okay. Okay, and then we have. So, how many ground lines are there?
There's a good 4 or 5. Well, actually, we're not at 4.
Actually, let me ask this. How many registers are there?
All 4.
3.
4.
Right?
No, up to 5. No.
The top, the middle, and the bottom. Okay? And I would say, I would argue, somebody can argue against me. I would argue that there are 2 ground lines there. Because I think, yeah. See a sandal bearer, right? Like, actually, it looks like he's like jumping on a diving board. You think? But I don't think that that's like, he's like floating. You know?
Looks like he's on.
You think? I don't know if that's part of the body or if it's actually like, here, I actually have a drawing of it. You think? Yeah. Is that like a, I don't know. Okay. And then, on the other side, sorry, Alex, did you not? Go ahead. There you go.
Focused.
What's that? many ground lines here? I think there are two. Because the bottom isn't really a ground line. They're like floating. And then the top. You think so? But a ground line is where the, like, it has to denote where, like, a figure is standing on.
Can you cap it as a ground line?
I think it's more a register. You know, because a ground line is kind of like showing where the figure is, like, standing on.
Barber has a sandal bearer.
I would like a sandal bearer. I want somebody to carry around my shoes for me.
So it was holy ground.
Lots of graphic stuff going on in this. You see it?
Yeah, but it's not really that graphic. It's
not. It's graphic. Check this out.
It's not that detailed.
Right here, these four guys on the right-hand side, they're decapitated and their heads are in between their legs.
It's not
just
yeah.
What's that? Right, pretty much. Didn't they cut off his fingers and then decapitate him?
Well, yeah, they dismembered him in different places. Decapitated.
Yeah. I'm telling you, we're just doing the same crap. Just different times here. Okay, did you guys get all the sound?
No.
All right. For their heads. Okay, we good? Turn and talk to the person next to you and see if you can come up with some, like, why. Some whys. Why was this made?
Of Egypt, region, or Egypt, into one kingdom.
Honey, can I use your hotspot again? Can you come over here with your password? Yeah, because it went to sleep and disconnected.
Welcome to my first lecture on Egyptian art. In your readings, I had you begin with the Last Judgment of Cuneiform from the Book of the Dead, since it provides such a good introduction to the Egyptian religion. In my lecture, I'm going to begin with our old friend, the Palette of Narmer, since it is the oldest Egyptian work we'll study. In fact, if you look at the College Board list, it's the second ancient Mediterranean work listed. Only the White Pamphlet of Rope is older. The content of this artifact has generated a lot of controversy. Maybe it commemorates the unification of Egypt after an actual battle. Maybe it presents a more mythical account of unification. And maybe, these seem to be the more recent theories, and the College Board loves recent theories. Maybe it symbolizes the daily journey of the sun god Re and or the balance between order and chaos that lies at the heart of the Egyptian religion.
I'm going to pause there, just so that you guys could take some notes on that, okay? What happens sometimes is archaeologists come up with new ideas. But you have to, all right, so perfect test question on this would be what? What could they ask? All of the following are what? What would they ask? Yes, exactly. All of the following could be significant reasons why the Palette of Narmer was made, except, right? And you have to know, unification of Upper and Lower Egypt. This was a commemoration of an event that happened over time, that it was a depiction of the canon, right? That, what else? What are some other reasons why? You just heard. Are we running out of steam?
Yeah.
Let me rewind, okay? You could go back home and you could listen again, okay? To listen.